Welcome to Bod's Mayhem Hour, your source for all hard rock, heavy metal, new metal, alternative, punk, horror punk, hardcore,
rock,
and all local bands with your host, John the Bod, a.k.a. the Bodfather.
What's up? This is Michael from Sunflower Dead, and you're listening to Bod's Mayhem Hour. Boom.
The views and opinions of the guests do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of Bod's Mayhem Radio Network, its staff, affiliates, or sponsors. Parental discretion is advised. Welcome to Bod's Mayhem Radio Network.
Hey everybody, welcome to Bod's Mayhem Hour. I'm your host, John the Bod, a.k.a. the Bod Father, and as always, I bring you guys awesome interviews. And today with me on the line is Mr. Michael Del Pazzo. He's from Sunflower Dead. He's the vocals, accordion, and piano player. So they got a new album that's getting ready to come out called Get Weird, and a new single from the album called Dance with Death. If you have not got to check this out, I highly suggest you check this out. So, man, how's it going so far?
It's going great. You know, I can't complain whatsoever. I'm sitting here on the beach in Huntington Beach and on a Friday morning in the sunshine, love and light. How you doing?
I'm very envy of you right now.
Yeah, it's all good. You know what? In probably about an hour, I'll have sunburn, so then you won't be envious. So balance it out.
So let's talk about the new album getting ready to come out, man. Favorite tracks off of it, if you can pick one, maybe, possibly, or Too Hard, or what?
I mean, at this point, it's Too Hard. I love the entire record. I mean, you know, we have Jonathan Davis on the title track, Time to Get Weird. I mean, you know, that's really rad. The single, obviously, I love Dance with Death. There's a piano ballad called Nothing, which I absolutely am in love with. There's another track. I mean, there's 10 tracks on the album, 10 songs, and there's not one that I don't like.
How was working with producer Dave Fortman, who's worked with, Evanescence, Slipknot, Godsmack, and Mikey Dooling from Gemini Syndrome? How was working with him?
Incredible. I mean, obviously, Dave's a genius. He's a musical genius for people that don't know, the way he hears harmonies and chord structures and stuff. And he just understands so much of what I wanted and the band wanted from this record that it was easy to tell him what we were looking for, and he delivered it very easy. And Mikey, on the flip side, he's got so much positive energy and an incredible, like, ear for, he just hears ideas. Hey, Mike, we might throw this here, throw that there, sing this, you know, I hear a guitar line. I mean, the two of them together was incredible and the best choice we could have made to do this record.
Michael, how much growth have you seen this band go through since the formation?
The growth has been the most amazing thing in my mind, because that was the idea behind all the touring we did on the first record. We didn't just tour to go be rock stars. We toured to go learn who we were as a band and what we wanted to be and what worked and what didn't. And when people hear this full second album, they're going to hear the difference in the polish on the record, the growth, how much fun we're having, yet still walking the line of being dead serious. I mean, you know, the growth was immense by all the touring we did on the first album cycle.
Let's talk about how hard you guys push yourself to come out with something new that may not be out there today. How hard do you guys keep trying to do that?
I don't know if we're ever, like, sat down and thought about trying to so much be new. I think for us it was the goal is to walk the path of trying to be ourselves 100%. I think that's how you be new. You don't try to emulate anyone else. You're really trying to figure out the core of who you are and put that out there. When you hit that on the button, that's when it's fresh to people. That's at least the way I see it, the way I've been trying to live my life.
How are fans reacting to the songs live, and how much does touring mean to you guys?
Touring means everything, because at the end of the day, we're a live band. I mean, that's what most fans will tell you. You know, recording is great and to be expressive is wonderful, but, you know, playing in front of people, you know, getting those reactions from them is the most, you know, overwhelming thing to go through as a musician, especially as it grows bigger and bigger. As far as the new songs live, we've done one tour. We did our first tour in Europe this summer in July, where we went over with Snot and opened for them all over the European mainland. And we actually opened for Korn for a couple shows on the 20th anniversary tour. And we did about 5 or 6 new songs every night, and they went over so well. I'm so thankful. I mean, by the second chorus, the people were singing along for these songs. So we know we're on to something.
I think it's great that Snot's still continuing to play after Lynn Strait. I really dig that band. It's great to still see them out there.
Yeah, I love those guys. They're all great friends of ours. And, you know, what a shame it was back in the day for that to happen for a band that was on the rise.
Yeah.
And then, but still, when you hang out with them, they're humble, they're cool. They go out there, the passion they have for what they do, they give it every night. I love those guys. In fact, I think they're going to do a new record, and I can't wait to hear it.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I can't wait to hear that either. That's made my day.
Yeah, well, I mean, the guy I have singing for him, Carl Bensley, he does such a great job, and his energy is incredible. Like, he totally does a tribute to Lynn, but yet he does it his own way, and his energy is awesome, just like Lynn's was. So they got the right guy for the job.
What can fans expect at a show from Sunflower Dad, Michael?
You know, you've never seen us before, you can expect to have a good time. And I think that's one thing that separates us from a lot of other bands out there is we're going up there to entertain you. There's no lie about that. We're not going to get you riled up and angry and go nuts. We're going to entertain you to put a smile on your face. So when you leave, you get to walk away saying, hey, you know, I got away from, you know, the doldrums of life for an hour when I was watching Sunflower Dad and had a really good time doing it.
And I'm glad you hit that right there, because that's what it is. When you're having a piss-poor day and everything's not going right and it's just a shitty day, you can go to your favorite concert that you've been wanting to go to or pop in your favorite album, and it just takes you to a different place, and you forget about everything.
Everything. I mean, that's what entertainment and expression is about. So that's, you know, what we decided straight on. We're not, you know, I mean, it's funny, we definitely walk the line of having fun and yet still being very serious, especially lyrically. But I want people to have a good time when they see us. You know, it's just so important, especially nowadays. You know, the world is tough. People need to have a good time.
That's what it's all about, and I'm glad you guys get it, because some, they don't, and I'll just throw it out there, honestly.
Yeah. Some people take themselves too seriously.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. What do you think Sunflower Dad brings to the table for music?
Well, musically, I mean, on the surface, I mean, I play the accordion. There's not many people that rock the accordion in a heavy band, but, you know, that's a little different. But, you know, what I think we bring is we bring a nice balance of all the genres that we grew up loving, all the decades of rock and metal that we love. We kind of pull from all those times. Like, we're not a band that has anything to do with any fad that's going on. We're not a theme band. We're a band that's basically looked at the history of rock and metal and music and said, you know what, we like these different things from this different time period. We're going to add that into what we do.
You know what, man? If Zakk Wylde can rock a banjo in a video or in a song, you guys can rock an accordion, so.
Oh, yeah, dude. I do. I get weird with this thing.
Weird Al, watch out.
Weird Al, watch out. That's right. Yeah, I'm coming for you.
Oh, man. What was it for you that made you want to become a musician, Michael? What was that spark, man?
Dude, when I was a kid, I never had MTV, right? So I went to my friend's house, and he had MTV, and he put it on, and the Twisted Sister video for We're Not Gonna Take It came on. And when I saw Dee Snider spin around after he said, I want to rock and become Dee Snider and Twisted Sister, I didn't know what it was. I just looked at my friend. I said, that's what I want to do. That's it. That sums it up right there.
Since the formation of Sunflower Dad and completing 6 U.S. tours over the years and sharing the stage with bands such as Korn, In This Moment, Hell Yeah, All That Remains, El Nino, Head P.E., Nonpoint, Snot, Powerman 5000, and etc., etc., what have you guys taken from those tours and from those bands?
The most important thing that I've learned is the consistency of the live show. The bigger the band we tour with, the more consistent we've noticed that they are every single night. I think that's what separates bands at different levels. It's the consistency, and then off stage, it's how you treat other people, you know, because everyone is paying attention to you, so there's no point in being a douchebag, you know. You know, everybody has off days, don't get me wrong. We're all in a bad mood at some point, but overall, how you treat people really says a lot for what happens to you in this industry or in life. So those are the two things that I've learned by touring with all these bands.
What's it mean to you when you receive an email from a fan or prior or after a show? They come up and tell you that your music has pulled them through a bad experience or gave them inspiration to overcome something that they just couldn't quite get over.
It doesn't matter how many times I get those emails, I'm always going to be blown away. It's incredible to get those. And you don't see day to day how you're touching people. You know, you were so locked into the music and the business of the band and whatnot. And then you get these emails from time to time that just kind of put you back on the right path and let you know why it is you're doing it. And when you get an email like that, you know, it's not about praise. It's about the fact that what you're doing that is so real to you is touching them and helping them through the day. And I mean, what's better than that? You know, it kind of connects you in a way. But it's good to be connected to life and other human beings.
Like I told you earlier, I dig your guys' stage present. You know, I like the horror theme stuff, and I'm glad that there's bands out there that respect it enough to bring it to the entertainment for music. And as a fan, thank you guys, man.
Oh man, thank you for enjoying it, and thank you for getting it. You know, and it's all about fun, and you know, if it gives you an outlet for the hour, awesome, because that's what it's doing for us too.
Yeah. When can we expect this album to come out, man? Get Weird. Let's talk about this. When can we get it in our hands, dude?
It's coming out digitally in North America on October 30th. You know, it had to come out on Halloween and the day before. Come on, this is, we're Sunflower Day with the way we look. So it's going to go on pre-order about 2 weeks before. The physical copies won't be ready for a while, and that's only because we're possibly going to do a record deal or not. We have to decide, and we're going to leave that to them. But digitally, it'll be out 10:30 only in North America, and it's worth it. It is. It's so much fun, the record, and I really think people are going to have a good time with it.
Well, you guys have full support on my show, and I'll definitely be playing it. And congratulations to all you guys.
Man, thank you so much. We appreciate that. Everyone in the band does, and everyone that works with us appreciates the support.
How can folks stay in touch with you guys, pick up the new album when it does come out, buy some merchandise? How can they do that, Michael?
We you know, we have sunflowerdead.com, and, of course, all the usual suspects, the Facebook, the Twitter, the Instagram, all that stuff. The records, as it digitally, will be available at all your digital retailers, iTunes, Apple, wherever you go, Amazon, to digitally download stuff. And then as far as, you know, merch and all that, we're redesigning the new merch for the new album cycle. So there will be a merch store on our Facebook and our website within the next month with new T-shirts designed. Hopefully a T-shirt just of my face. Just kidding. You know, new stuff coming out. So it should be there within a month. And if you keep checking the website, you'll see that.
Before I let you go, will you care to do a promo for the show?
Sure, man. Okay, cool. What's up? This is Michael from Sunflower Dead, and you're listening to Bod's Mayhem Hour. Boom.
Everybody stick around. Coming up, and you only hear these interviews right here on Bod's Mayhem Hour. Please go out and check out Sunflower Dead. They have some phenomenal music. Just really, really great music, and just really great to see new stuff that coming out there. So check them out, everybody. Thanks, guys.
Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.